The outside of Georgia's Capitol building looks pretty much the same as it did when it was built 132 years ago. But this year, the building's curb appeal changed a lot. Workers spent several months outside the Capitol erecting an imposing metal fence that now encircles nearly the entire building. The fence is 8 feet tall, peaked with pointed spikes. The state, led by Governor Brian Kemp, quietly decided to construct the fence following a series of protests last year. Vigorous protests of police violence frequently targeted the Capitol, with state troopers and National Guard providing protection for the building. Some smaller demonstrations on behalf of former President Trump's false claims of election fraud likewise appeared outside, and at least one ended up inside the Capitol in front of the Secretary of State's office across from the governor's office. Within days of that protest, the fence started going up, delivering at least one high-profile critic.
I think that of symbols of independence and self-government, fences around government property is wrong.
Democrat Roy Barnes was governor of Georgia and served in the legislature more than 20 years. The fence, he says, was a knee-jerk reaction.
I think it sends a terrible signal to the people of Georgia that that its leadership has to be protected by a spiked fence. I think that was an overreaction.
Although some lawmakers have grumbled a little bit about the fence, it's worth noting that not a single one of them, Democrat or Republican, in the last legislative session introduced any legislation that would have defunded or otherwise opposed the Capitol's new 8-foot-tall metal fence.